Phytoplankton. You ever heard of phytoplankton? Phytoplankton, phyto means works on sunlight. Plankton, little tiny things, you know, they float around in the ocean, that kind of thing. And what phytoplankton is basically giant clouds of little tiny plants that fill the oceans. It's at the bottom of the food chain, meaning that if it collapses, so too does all other marine life. And if all the marine life collapses, then most land life collapses. And there's a reason why that for that, and that is that about half of all the oxygen in our atmosphere comes from phytoplankton in our oceans. So kill off the phytoplankton, and the world as we know it ends. The bad news, we're killing off the phytoplankton. Yikes. FYI to everybody here, I just got a notice that my link to the Telos server is down. I'm trying to bring it back up, but I think it's going to lock up. Back in 2007, a study was done on the reproduction rate of phytoplankton in the Gulf of Maine. And scientists were totally freaked out to discover that the reproduction rate had decreased by a factor of 5, as in 500%. As in the amount of phytoplankton that can be produced in a day now takes 5 days to produce. Now keep in mind, every fish, everything, pretty much, lives on phytoplankton or lives on something that lives on phytoplankton. And now a new study out of the Bigelow Laboratory of Ocean Sciences finds that phytoplankton reproduction, which has been crashing in Maine, that was where they found that 500% drop, it hasn't bounced back. Now, you know, overtly and explicitly, that's bad news for Maine's marine industries, because the food chain that leads to every fish we eat starts with phytoplankton. No phytoplankton, no fish. But even more frightening, this phenomenon isn't exclusive to the Gulf of Maine. It's happening all over the planet. As the science journal Nature published back in 2010, at that point in time, and this was it's been picking up, and it's starting to pick up exponentially rather than linearly, the world was in 2010 losing 1% of its phytoplankton every single year. And in the northern hemisphere, places like Maine, since 1950, we've seen a 40% drop-off in phytoplankton. So we're not just talking about Maine fisheries getting wiped out. We're talking about fisheries around the planet. We're talking about a catastrophic shakeup of the global food chain. And it's not just about food. I mean, we all like to eat. But we all like to breathe even more. Person can go a few days without eating. You can only go a few minutes without breathing. And we can thank phytoplankton for giving us oxygen to breathe. As I said, roughly half the world's oxygen supply comes from phytoplankton, which inhales carbon dioxide and exhales oxygen, and in the process locks up that carbon. But phytoplankton are being killed off by a 1-2-3 punch of warmer waters, changing salinity levels, and most importantly, increasing levels of carbonic acid in the ocean. An acid formed when the ocean absorbs the carbon dioxide that we pump into the atmosphere when we burn coal, oil, gasoline, and natural gas. The global warming from our burning these fossil fuels? It is melting the permafrost and the ice around the Arctic Circle. Now, what is this doing? It's exposing ancient peat bogs, vegetation that in some cases hundreds of thousands, in some cases hundreds of millions of years ago, have been trapped under that ice. Now you'll recall James Hansen said, you know, if this global warming continues, the world is going to, you know, it'll establish a new equilibrium, but it's not the one to which human life is adapted. So anyhow, this peat, this million-year-old vegetable matter, vegetation, all blackened and browned and, you know, whatever, starts decomposing when it gets thawed out. And that decomposition releases methane, which is a greenhouse gas that is 25 times, as in 2,500%, more potent at warming our atmosphere than carbon dioxide. A team of ecologists with the University of Alaska Fairbanks has found so far, I mean, this is pretty scary, these methane leaks bubbling up. Guess how many they've found so far? All around the north. Northern Siberia, northern Alaska, northern China. 150,000 major methane leaks, bubbling methane up into the Arctic, into the waters around the Arctic. As the ice cap gets smaller and smaller and the water gets larger and larger, you know, the governments are all sitting around going, oh boy, we can drill in the Arctic, or oh boy, we can have maritime navigation across the Arctic. Meanwhile, all this permafrost is melting and all this methane is going into the atmosphere. So to recap, humans are releasing carbon into the atmosphere, which is causing temperatures to rise, which is melting the polar ice caps, which is releasing methane, which is causing temperatures to rise even faster and making the oceans even more acidic, which is contributing to the death of phytoplankton, the very phytoplankton on which the global food chain depends for survival, and we humans depend on for air. If this continues, we're looking at the end of the world as we know it, possibly in this century. And the Republicans in power and the oil barons that they're slaves to, they're determined to let the phytoplankton die off. These lawmakers include people like Virginia State Delegate Chris Stoll, who stripped out the term sea level rise from a state study on climate change because he said it's a liberal code word. The oil, coal, and natural gas barons are now hiring the same phony scientists and using the same tactics that the tobacco companies used in the 1990s to raise doubt about clear scientific evidence that their products are actually killing people, only in this case, killing the earth. $300 million in 2010 in that election came in from outside corporate money, a lot of which came from climate change denying oil, coal, and natural gas corporations. What's the result of that? Every single freshman House of Representatives Republican has gone on record to deny the existence of man-made global climate change. Talk about fiddling while Rome burns. Meanwhile, phytoplankton continues to die off because global temperatures continue to rise. If we haven't already hit a tipping point, and James Hansen is suggesting maybe we have, when it comes to climate change, you know, he was saying we have to worry about 300 parts per million. We're about 350 parts per million. We started, you'll recall, I mean, back during the Nixon administration, we were in the high 200s, 280, 290 parts per million of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere. We are now above 400 parts per million. And just like nobody in our press is talking about, you know, this secret meeting that was over at the caucus room restaurant where the Republicans plotted to bring down the Obama administration, nobody in the corporate press is talking about what I just shared with you, which, by the way, is common knowledge in Europe, where they're actually trying to do something about this. There are countries around the world that get it. The Kyoto Accord came out of Kyoto, Japan. The Japanese get it. Only in the United States, where our Supreme Court has said that coal and oil and natural gas barons can corrupt both politicians and the corporate media with their money, only in the United States is this even considered a debate.